In one of my previous videos, I unboxed my first order from the sponsor of this video, PCBWAY.com. Chinese PCB manufacturer who offers good quality PCB manufacturing and PCB assembly services for affordable price. The content was these panels of small PCBs. These are ports for switch mode LED drivers for BMW X3's tail lights. The second generation X3, the F25 in specific. That model has somewhat infamous problem with its LED taillights. Taillight going dark sounds like an easy fix, but with these modern LED lights, it's not always a simple thing. As far as I know, only official way of fixing those taillights is buying the whole taillight instead of just replacing a bulb or broken PCB. And how much does the taillight cost? Well, genuine ones have price tag with three figures. Way too expensive fix for a small problem. The problem that causes those taillights to go out is the linear LED driver inside the taillight. That driver is wasting most of its input power as heat, and that causes the solder joints to fail, stopping it from working altogether. I designed this more efficient driver port to fit in place of original LED driver port, and I made sure that the installation is simple by using the exact same connector as on the original PCB. The base of this project is cheap LED driver IC with correct output current set using correct sense resistor. The circuit also includes a PI filter in power input to smooth out some of the noise. I got this SMD stencil with my order. I'll use it while assembling one port. I'm not doing any more than that for now until I get more comfortable reflowing with my new oven. The connector I'm going to use can't be reflowed, so I'm blocking its holes in the stencil with tape. I'll apply the solder paste, and as I'm not good at guessing how much solder paste I need, I'll just add at least enough, so I don't need to add more during the process. My reflow oven isn't in the same room as where I film my videos. After the components have been placed, I will take this board, do the reflow magic, and clean the boards with rubbing alcohol pad, then I will come back. Here's the almost finished board. Now all I need to do is solder the connector and test if this works. To test this LED driver, I will use this messy thing. This can be plugged into the board, and there are few diodes in series simulating the LEDs of the taillight. I have multimeter measuring current going through the diodes, i.e. the output current, and that is in amps. Power comes from my bench power supply that is set to 14.4 volts, and when I turn on the power supply, output from this board should be close to 240 milliamps, like it is. And at the same time, the input current is just about 70 milliamps, which is much better than with the linear driver. This schematic is based on the schematic from the controller's datasheet. You should check the datasheet and adjust the values to match your needs if you are using this IC. If you are still watching, do me a favor and like this video and subscribe for more electronics related videos. Thanks. Bye.